I'm Kiana Edison, the freshman homecoming attendant.
I'm Claudia Cummings, and I'm the sophomore homecoming attendant.
I'm Abby Shaw, and I'm the junior homecoming attendant. Your senior homecoming attendant is Micaiah Crisp, and your homecoming queen is Michaela Holcroft.
The homecoming ceremony starts at 6:25. Prior Tigers will take the field immediately after the homecoming ceremony.
Kickoff against the Gravett Lions starts at 7 p.m. The Rise Squad theme is America, so let's see your red, white, and blue.
Tonight also marks the 19th anniversary of 9/11. On September 11, 2001, 19 Al-Qaeda took over four airplanes and carried out suicide attacks against targets in the United States. Two planes struck the Twin Towers of the World Trade Center, the first at 8:46 a.m. and the second at 9:03 a.m. A third plane hit the Pentagon just outside of Washington, D.C. at 9:45 a.m. and a fourth plane crashed in a field in Shanksville, Pennsylvania at 10:10 a.m. In all, 2,977 people died and more than 6,000 were injured. America will never forget.
I was in sixth grade when 9/11 happened. I was in my science class. I just kind of remember that for the rest of the day, I think we went outside and kind of everybody was a little bit shook up. And then whenever I got home, my parents were pretty shook up for the day. So that's what I remember about it.
So 9/11 happened about a year out of when I was out of college. I was a manager at Enterprise Rent-A-Car, and an employee of a dealership that we were in came running by my office and stated that one of the Twin Towers had been hit by a plane. So we ran to the TV in the customer lounge and we watched the aftermath of that building, and then we actually watched live the second building getting hit. It changed everything at that point. I can remember airplanes being grounded, things were being delayed. Everything just seemed different. Our country, the unity of our country changed. People decided to be more for our country and serve our country. So it was a different time in my life and something that I will never forget. And I'm thankful for the men and women that serve our country now and then.
On 9/11, I was coaching at Bonita Public Schools, and we were at seventh grade football practice. We came in from practice, and on the TV, we saw one of the towers burning, and then saw the plane hit the second tower. Then we watched it, news about it all day in class, and it was just unbelievable that anything like that could happen. The only thing that ever happened like that was the bombing in Oklahoma City, the federal building, but it was just really unbelievable.
On 9/11/01, I was in this high school. Miss Roberson's class. It was Miss Helvey's class at that time, and it was still computer class, but we didn't have TVs in all the classrooms like we do now, so another teacher came running in and said, something's happened, it's really bad. So the whole class jumps out, runs to another classroom, and we watch it on TV. It was almost unbelievable to see that this something like that actually happened on our soil. Initial thoughts were anger, really. Upset, anger. Didn't really understand it because I was a sophomore at the time. So I didn't really know how bad it was until later in the day when all the news started covering it. But it's that's how I felt.
I remember at the time the World Trade Center was hit, I was coaching football, and it seemed I'd never been through anything like that or seen anything like that, an attack on our country. I felt a strong sense of patriotism at that time and, you know, wanted to do something, but I didn't know what to do. But I think it kind of pulled us together.
I remember when 9/11 happened. I had just taken my oldest son to school, and I came home and sat down on the couch and saw the second plane hit the World Trade Center. And my husband, our phone just kept ringing and ringing and ringing and ringing. And my husband was in bed, and he was activated in the National Guard that day. And since then has done three tours in Afghanistan. And it really impacted my life. I went straight to school and got my son out of school, and because we didn't really know what was going to happen next with our family.
I remember I was at school and somebody mentioned that it'd been damaged, the Trade Center, and I went in and watched it on video, and I thought, how could somebody flying an airplane run into the World Trade Center? And about that time the second airplane hit, and kind of like everybody else, it's kind of shock, and you're thinking, oh my gosh, what's going on? Unsure about what's going on, what's happening to our country. And then you start hearing about all the other planes, and one hitting the Pentagon, and one going down in Pennsylvania. And then you kind of get angry and start getting a sense of pride in your country. And I watched our country go from anger to pride, and just people getting more patriotic. And you saw flags everywhere, and people were just coming together. And it was a bad time, but it was kind of a good time too, being able to see people come together like that.
Well, I was a sophomore at Hillsdale Free Will Baptist College, and I had a Tuesday-Thursday class at 8 o'clock. It was very early, because I was not a very good student. And I was about maybe 5 minutes late to class, and the class I was going to, the professor was very strict, always had a tie on, and very formal, and he was just sitting on the desk, which was weird for him to do that. So I walked in and I was like, hey, what's going on? Nobody was in the class. And he told me to go back to my dorm and watch the news because we're under attack. Like, he was a chaplain in the army, and so he thought that it was an attack from the get-go, not just a bad accident. So I went back to my dorm room, and my roommates were watching the news, but it didn't even really dawn on me what was going on. I thought it was a movie or something. It was just crazy. And we watched the news for like 2 hours, saw the second plane hit, the Twin Towers. It was a scary time. It really was. I called my family to check on them. My girlfriend at the time, later wife, Mrs. Cosm, she was going to school in Nashville at the time, and I had actually walked her to her plane on that Sunday before. Like, that's something that never happens now. Like, it was a smaller plane, and I like went into the airport and actually walked out onto the tarmac, like walked her to the plane. Can't even do that now. But I called her and checked on her, and she was really freaked out. There was a lot of unease, a lot of unknowns about what was going to happen. Were we going to go to war? Was there going to be a draft? It was a very scary time.
On September 11th, I remember I was in 8th grade. We just finished up football practice, and one of the guys had ran in and said that the towers in New York City had been hit. I remember going into school, going to Mr. Robertson's science class, and he had the TV turned on that day, and I remember watching the South Tower fall. There was a range of emotions. We were mad, some were sad. A lot of us didn't understand what was going on because we were so young. In the days and weeks to follow, we just heard multiple stories of firefighters, police officers, EMS workers that had ran into the building to try to save people. I think that's what ultimately led me to become a police officer, just to go out and be a public servant, just to help my citizens and help other people out.
On 9/11, I remember sitting in my 8th grade math class, and they brought in a TV for us to watch the events unfold. I remember the thoughts I had after watching all of that was kind of confused as to why people would want to hurt innocent Americans. And I just remember the changes that took place in the nation after the attacks that day.
All right, so 9/11, September 11th, 2001, I was a freshman in college. It was my first semester in college, Northeastern, and I was still living with my parents. It was on a Tuesday, because I know I only had Monday, Wednesday, Friday classes, and that Tuesday, I was asleep on the couch, and at 9 o'clock, my dad, I heard him run through the house and turn the TV on and hit me and woke me up, said, hey, we're being attacked, and from that point on, I just was glued to the TV, and seeing all the things that were going on and all the emotions that on people's faces and what they were doing. It's crazy. Didn't know how to feel, didn't know what to expect. And then as they were videoing the first tower and all the things and all the questions that the reporters and everything, everybody was asking, you could see live another plane come in. And I'm sure all of you have seen that same footage now, but watching it live was just, I mean, it was heartbreaking. Not knowing what was going on and who was attacking us. Just my dad said, we're being attacked. But I knew from that point on, man, our country was in trouble. Our country was getting ready to obviously probably go to war. And I mean, I had friends that I had just graduated with less than 6 months before that I knew were in basic training and they were in the military, and I didn't know what life was going to be like for them, because I mean, there was a lot of questions to be answered. But so the emotions were just uncontrollable. So I mean, it was something that changed my life forever, something I'll never forget, where I was, what happened, and proud to be in America today because of it.
Where were you when the world stopped turning on that September day?